Emerilia, Book 9, of Myths and Legends, written by Michael Chatfield, read by Tristan Morris. Chapter 1. Welcome to Emerilia. Dave's mirror of communication activated, receiving a message being broadcasted from Emerilia. All Stone Raiders are to immediately return to Terra. All members of the Terra Alliance are to move into readiness positions, ready for immediate deployment. This is not a drill. Josh's voice cut through the silence that had descended over Party Zero as they stopped, looking out over the asteroid and the heavens above. You heard the man, Dia yelled. All of Party Zero turned and rushed toward the portal to the ice planet, their bodies mere blurs. None of them talked as they rushed from the asteroid to the ice planet, and then through Null to Pandora's box, through the power facility and into Terra. Bob had taken a separate portal in Pandora's box to reach the Datskun. Automatons and carts were the only things in the sky. Massive barges carrying troops from across Emerilia were moved to and from the teleport pads. The city streets had quickly been cleared by Shard. The businesses and people of Terra, as well as their visitors, looked in shock as the military units that had been stuck in training or were being called up rushed into Terra. No one was allowed in the sky. Shard took over the automatons to move everyone without having any accidents. People who had been relaxing in their taverns now rushed through the city in squads, their eyes hard as they moved toward their barracks. Party Zero called up their armor. Everyone was in a state of shock with all the movements going on. Party Zero, there is a cart outside waiting for you. Please board it. Steve, I could use your help in organizing the movements of the city. Shard's voice came from overhead Party Zero.
Linking in,
Steve said, as Party Zero moved toward the waiting carts. As soon as they were secured, the carts took off toward Stone Raider Towers. Dave found Dia's hand, holding it as they rushed forward. Across Emerilia, the same scene took place. With the interfaces and party chat, information passed at an alarming rate. The message was simple and terrifying. The portals had opened, and creatures from the other planes were now descending. With them were creatures that were part of the Myths and Legends event. People checked their weapons. City guard and military units were put on full readiness as the city's defenses were checked. The horns of the elves were heard across Markolm as the military units within their beautiful towers marched out to the city walls in crisp, orderly lines. Old alliance agreements were checked over, and units were sent to Terra as per the Terra Alliance agreement. Tribes checked their defenses and reached out to one another in aid. The ground around the Dwarven Mountains shook with the sound of drumbeats. The Dwarven warbands called to service. Within those mountains, bellows worked harder as weapons were checked and armor was fitted. Dwarves donned their armor, moving into their warbands and war clans. Artillery was checked and tested. In the north of Ophir, war clans that had been based out of the Mythzia Mountains, training behind their massive defensive wall, now moved out of the mountains and to preset positions. War drums filled the Kufotel Forest, rolling down from the Mythzia Mountains as horns from the Kufotel elves called the people back to their city in the forest. Retired and reserve rangers donned their armor and moved to full readiness. Several war clans and supporting Kufotel elves gathered themselves together, marching out of the defended land and toward Cliff Hill. Cliff Hill had grown into a massive city now, larger than even Omal. Their defenses were checked as they manned their walls and watched for danger. Bob watched this all, a solemn look on his face as he checked the action logs that showed what the Empire had done.
Those motherfuckers,
Bob said with a cold voice.
They opened almost all of the portals that hadn't been discovered, and random ones that have to link Emerilia to the other systems containing aggressive species. 12 races in total. Even races that were closed off due to having low numbers, or because they unbalanced Emerilia before. They also spammed the damn spawn points. Do they just not care anymore?
Bob went through the information and frowned. he typed out a quick message with all that he knew, sending it on to Party Zero, Fire, and Water. He stood up from his chair and headed back toward the portal that connected to Pandora's box.
I might not be able to do anything on the main stage of Emerilia yet, but I can support them from the rear with what we're doing in the Null system and Moonbase, Bob said,
his voice hard and his eyes cold. He would take over the various projects that were ongoing to take some of the pressure off Party Zero and the others. Josh looked at the message he had received from Bob. His lined face grew darker, and he quickly shared it with the other leaders in the Alliance and Lucy, who would share it outward to everyone.
Okay, well, it looks like nearly everyone is here.
Josh looked to everyone in the room. A few were missing, but they would be there shortly.
All of the undiscovered portals across Emerilia, as well as a number of spawn points, have become active. We've got creatures from all of the different realms and planes now on Emerilia. Most of them are around cities. I was going to call a meeting later today anyway to address something else. It seems that there were a number of subquests connected to the event of Myths and Legends. Most of the disruptions and quests that have been given out in the last couple of months dealt with creatures and people who were released for the event. Thankfully, with our people being out in the world, a number of these quests were dealt with. However, now it looks like it will be hard to focus on just these quests, as we have to deal with this new threat. I suggest to everyone that they should first secure their cities. The lands of Emerilia might not be safe in the near future to roam around in.
If we lock ourselves up in our cities, how will we support ourselves? This isn't a long-term solution, one of the leaders said.
It is not, but with all these creatures and people that are now roaming Emerilia, we don't know enough about them or what is going to happen. It is best if people hole up, train to their limit, and be ready for what's about to come. Whatever that might be, Josh said.
Do we have a plan to deal with this?
Another asked.
We first need to find out where these portals are. This is something that the various scouting elements of the Alliance are looking into. Once we know their locations, our aim is to move from portal to portal, set up bases that will stand in the way of the portal and its exit, stopping anything from exiting, Josh said.
Now I wish we could use that shield Dave has come up with for the portals. If we were to show it off, it would show that we know how to use portal technology, and the Ducal might not take too kindly to that. And if we blatantly destroy the portals, then we would get penalized heavily.
Barring the use of Dave's technology, they would have to do it the hard way. Fight whatever came through those portals, and hold them off as Emerilia dealt with their own issues before they could even think about heading through these portals to try to secure the locations on the other side.
If they are invading, have the defensive castles like the ones surrounding Goblin Mountain appeared? Another asked.
We have had sightings of the castles. We have teams ready to move to these locations in order to take over these castles before others get there, Lucy said.
We only have a dozen Onos at our disposal right now. We need more from the Aleph before we can put one at every castle location, so we can support the people who are capturing these places.
We are working with the Aleph to increase the production of Onos at this time, Florence said, having rushed over from Verloon.
Make sure that your forces are ready. We will hold 30% of our forces here. The rest will be capturing castles, or they will be assisting in clearing up any quests that have been left open in the cities as part of this alliance. If we get all those quests sorted out, we should flush out some more creatures from the event, securing our towns and quickly gaining experience to level up people.
It was clear that Josh's words weren't a request, but an order. Party Zero all heard a similar briefing from Essa, who stood in front of a number of groups that had been picked out from the fighting forces, Stone Raiders, and other guilds that had joined the Alliance.
You are to act as capture parties. This means that you will be moved across Emerilia in order to move to castles that have been located around various active portals. You will move in, place a drop pad, and begin capturing the area. An Ono will be shifted to your location to allow reinforcements in to support you. We need these castles. If the forces exiting the portals take these castles, they will have a firm beachhead into Emerilia, making it easier for them to launch attacks and move in more forces to Emerilia. Each of you has been sent a location. All fees are waived from the Onos with these tokens.
Essa threw out the token.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.